So, welcome all our listeners. Today, again, I'm with my good friend Sheldon DeLima. We are going to discuss about climate change and global warming
Hi, hi everybody.
and all the other problems we are facing because of all the emissions and deforestation and all that.
Actually, before you dive into that, it is even, I think it's a topic of debate even whether global warming is a good thing or a bad thing.
Why is it a good thing?
Not a good thing, but there are debates that say since it's an evolution, the man evolved and things evolve, it is not necessarily a bad thing. It's just a change, and all changes are always perceived as bad till until unless happens, and they go, oh, good, it happened. I mean, sometime down the line, the apes must have been like, hey, no, we're not going to change it. Oh, now we're humans. Okay, it's good, very good, very good. We don't want to be animals anymore.
No, but you don't think that over the la since the industrial age, all the emissions and all the carbon dioxide and all the other methane and all those other gases that we are emitting into the atmosphere, it must have no effect, must have some effect at least. No, even something you cannot deny the fact that all that gases and all have contributed to some change in our environment. Maybe who knows whether it is global warming or global cooling, but something it must have done, no?
No, that is very true. I'm just saying that there is a debate out there. I'm not taking any sides here. I'm still on the fence because, see, as I was saying, everything that ever happened that led up to today was a must. I mean, there's nothing that came up like, oh, why the hell do we need this? I don't think so. I mean, like, even there are people who would ask me, why you need a V8 shell? I'm like, V8, need a V8 because we can do it. It's as simple as that. So it's a debate. I mean, it's a debatable topic, you can say. But on the same, I mean, like, who knows? I mean, if water levels rise and things go underwater, we may develop to, gills fall,
This is ridiculous. I don't know why I'm talking to you about this. Now, but we can take it as a challenge. If we can convince people like you, that means we can convince almost anyone who are like denying the fact that climate change is occurring and it is a need of the hour to actually do something about it.
There are presidents who do not agree with you, Julian.
Let me give you an example. Suppose something is inedible, you'll eat it.
No, obviously not.
The
The
same
word
way.
inedible is inedible, so I will not eat
So
it.
in the same way, there are some things which you are not supposed to do.
See, we are all a carbon-based life form. Okay, so everything is carbon. So we are just basically transforming one form of carbon to another form of carbon. I don't see the harm in it. Because if it was not supposed to be done, it would not be done. There would be a lock. I mean, like, the
So,
universe itself has got its own mechanisms. It would have locked us from doing such a thing.
no, what will at the most what will happen is we'll go extinct, but the other animals will continue living. Those people who can survive, and maybe after a few million years, they'll be.
Probably. I mean, like, I'm not going to live that long to see
So
it,
we have to
so.
decide whether we have to be we have to continue on Earth or we have to.
See, quite frankly, it's like this, okay? I mean, we may be wrong. Armageddon may come. I mean, at least the movies say so. But are we really going to be around to see that?
But your children and their 10 generations, 20 generations, 30, 40 generations will.
Oh. I mean, like, okay. So you see, it's inevitable if you ask me, okay? It's just about
Why?
prolonging
We
it.
can change our habits, no?
No, but if see, everything that starts has to end. So, life on
So you
Earth.
don't feel, you don't have, you see, if you're a person who's interested in science and
Yeah, so
new
I.
technology
Yeah,
and all.
exactly. So, I find this situations that come arise that are going to come ahead, the predictions, to be a challenge. In fact, it is a call for more development. Necessity is the mother of invention. If there is no necessity, there'll be no invention. See, for all we may make devices to breathe underwater.
So you're in the
I'm. Yeah, I'm
you're
pretty sure.
supposed you are going to colonize Mars or something like that, right?
No, I say please colonize Earth first. I mean, like, who the hell knows what's on Mars? I still can't understand why people waste money and time trying to talk to extraterrestrials. I mean, like, try learn to talk to people on Earth first, man.
That okay, there I agree with you.
was like, so you're trying to communicate and make devices to communicate aliens. Duh! Try communicate with people on Earth. Make a universal translator for all I don't care. You don't waste money on that.
This is good, no? Google has done that.
Yes.
Translate.
Yeah, the Google Translate is amazing. In fact, actually, there was a time when there was a phone called Nokia. I mean, it was pretty much there, but not there as such.
I have a Nokia phone.
No, that is not Nokia. The original Nokia, which was Scandinavian, I believe.
Finnish.
Finnish. The original Finnish Nokia, that had an awesome translator. I mean, it was born leaps and bounds ahead, but then again, PR and marketing was something they had knew nothing about.
Okay, but Nokia phones were amazing when you used to send SMSs and all. Okay, anyways, what
Yeah,
I'm trying to
come
say
back
is,
to
the, you know,
see, as I said, we
at
need the, see what I say is, if there is global warming taking place, there are engineers, there are scientists, there are people who know stuff who will counter it. We just don't
the
need to go back to primitive lifestyle.
No, the
Just
thing
see,
is,
tomorrow you're going
the
to tell me that I cannot eat or do certain thing because it's polluting the air. So you want me to eat raw mass like this, raw meat like this to eat earlier? That's ridiculous.
No, what I'm saying to you, what if this choice is not between raw meat and cooked meat? It is between meat and no meat. Because
Are
meat
such
is one of the
ignorance.
meat is one of the
I know
most
that. I know.
polluting.
That's why. I hear it. I hear that argument. I mean, like there are some people who tell me that there is land being used, so many acres of land and so many acres of water, so many liters of water. I'm like, at one side you tell me so many liters of water are getting used, and the second time you tell me there's too much water everywhere it's raining. I'm like, babe, make up your mind.
Arey,
Fix your
see,
problem, and then we'll find a
no,
solution.
too much of water, you cannot recharge the aquifers in the which are which.
See, I mean, like, if you heard of a country called Israel, small country, very nice country, but they have got saline water everywhere. You convert it to drinking water and use it. There is technology to do it. People just don't want to do it. See, there's no need. See, it's like this, okay? At one time, okay, what was an expense was a luxury. Today, it's become a need. And when it becomes a need, I mean, human beings have always proven that they can go beyond everything and do what is necessary. See, what differentiates us from animals is this, okay? If a forest catches fire, the animals will run away because they have nothing else to do. The man will build a house and stay. He will not say, "Oh, the tree
Oh,
is
how will
burned."
get burned?
No, I'm saying, like, if the tree was the house and the tree had to
Okay,
burn,
okay.
man would be like, "Okay, cool, dude, I'll find cement, I'll make a house of my own. I'll stay in that same area, I won't move."
No, but the problem is, okay, see, suppose if it depends on if the fire comes and he depends on the animals and the plants for food, everything gets burnt, he can't eat his own house, no?
No, but then they see, that's what I'm trying to tell you, no? There is going to be a solution somewhere. We have got, I don't know if you heard of this, but there are people in factories processing food, artificial food, which was supposed to be there. I mean, like, I'm talking about the meat industry itself. So since the meat industry is taking up water and all, there are people inventing things that taste like meat.
Plant-based meat.
Plant-based meat, yes, exactly.
Okay, that's a step forward in the right
Exactly.
direction.
No, that's what I'm saying. So I'm like, I say the whole worrying about it is a pain in the rear end. Just live it, enjoy it. Our hometown is having a few
No.
is a few degrees cooler ever since there's a global warming. I'm like, are you serious?
No,
I have been buying sweaters
they're
for the
not
past
saying
3 years.
global warming, they're saying climate change.
Yeah, now
Climate.
they change the phrases. When we were younger, they were global warming, global warming, global warming. This glass house effect and greenhouse effect and God knows what nots.
But
Now, 10 years down the line, they have realized that they were wrong because,
now
90% of the times,
say okay,
terrorists are wrong.
let us look at it one way. Okay, now see fish in the fish market.
Yeah, lovely.
Since this whole thing is happening, like people are temperatures are rising and all means you can something is happening.
Ah,
I don't know what is
change. There is change.
there is change. You agree on that at
Yes,
least.
there is change, definitely.
Let us including inflation and price rise for the fish prices, they are going up or down. Means you exclude inflation.
See, it is all about demand and supply, okay? This is economics.
No, what if the fish in the sea are becoming less?
If the fish in the sea are becoming less, only the rich will eat fish.
So all the poor people must starve and die or.
No, they can eat rice, right?
So, okay, you agree that eating meat is a luxury.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying it comes to a point. That's why I said, no, there. See, That's what I'm saying. With change, things change. I just said it earlier. See, sometimes what is a luxury will become something that is essential for everybody's life, and vice versa is also true because it is a balance out of equations. See, I'll tell you, this is a ridiculous thing, but once upon a time, cookware was made in cast iron. Okay? Then they moved to aluminium and stainless steel and enamels and plastics and whatnot craps. And now they are going back to cast iron.
Mud.
And even cast iron is getting outdated now. Recently, I went down to get utensils, and somebody was telling me there was a lady in the shop asking if I could get a if she could get mud utensils because she was like,
That's the best,
the
actually.
meat doesn't taste so good in this cast iron.
Mud utensils are we are evolved to eat in mud only, actually.
Yeah, whatever. But I'm trying to tell you, my point is like how the bell bottoms had a revisit in 2000. Things are bound to go in circles. It doesn't, nothing happens. I'm like, worrying about it is not. I mean, you can imagine, I still remember we were in
But
school,
tell me,
Y2K,
if the
Y2K, Y2K. I like, Y2K what?
no,
Till we
but
understood the problem to solve, I'm like, Christ.
no, but what I'm trying to say is, if the forest is on fire, you obviously you'll take precautions that your house doesn't catch fire, no?
Yeah, obviously, that is true. That is amazingly true. That is absolutely right. But the thing is, what I'm saying is, yes, you have to take precautions. You have to be. But you cannot live in paranoia or live in the fear that the world is coming to an end or etc., etc.
But
Or.
there's always a tipping point, no?
Yeah, see, what I'm saying, Julian, is there is change and you have to be prepared for change, not be prepared for,
Now,
reverse gear.
okay, suppose you're going in
See,
a.
I'll take an example, okay? When I was in school, when we were in school, okay, I mean, we were in
Now,
classmates,
suppose.
we were in school, we were told in Vision 2020, do you even remember that
Yeah,
lesson?
remember
We would be
the
read,
oxygen
yeah,
mask,
we'd
and
be
it's coming
oxygen mask.
through. In Delhi, they're selling oxygen
Baba, that
cylinders.
is Delhi. I have a lot of words for Delhi, but we cannot say those words here.
Okay.
But it is a business gimmick, man. I mean, like, see, that's why I said somebody saw the opportunity to make money. He made money. He's making money. He's minting money. No, I mean, like, Vision 2020, when we had and our teacher, I can't remember who was a class teacher, but I can still remember. She told us that there will be no wood. At that time, everything has to be plastics. And I got so hooked up onto it. I was researching and reading about plastics and metaplastics and metaphors and this plastic and that kind of plastic. And till date, I have not seen any of those damn plastics. Nanoplastic and carbon
That
infused plastic and
doesn't.
this plastic and that. I just did my entire bedroom out of wood, man, last month. The entire bedroom is of wood.
So what I'm trying to say is,
That's what I'm saying. See,
if you're driving in a car and you reach this intersection, and you're not going to this break the traffic light, no?
No, obviously not.
Huh, so what I'm saying is, if there is something
This is
happening,
not
if
on
the
radio.
fish in the sea are becoming less, you can't say I want to eat squids every time. No, the squids only
See,
will
no, see,
die.
that's what I'm saying. No, see, just like how the lion, tigers had come to almost extinction and then they repopulated them, somebody will take up the job and repopulate. I mean, there are a lot of people who do all this.
What if nobody takes it up
I mean,
then?
like, recently I heard about a tortoise that was, there were only 12 of them, and from that 12, there were only two males. And that, some NGO took it up to the poor guy, I mean, the poor turtle. He populated the entire thing to 2,000
So, you know,
turtles. Two
somewhere
thousand. Can you imagine how many kids that guy has and how many of his kids he must have actually done?
tortoise.
And they're supposed to be slow. So I'm imagining. Imagine that.
And
Anyways.
what
So,
even in human beings, at one point in time, I heard somewhere, I'm not sure if it's right, there were only 10,000 or some 10,000 pairs or something like that way.
are you kidding me?
Yeah, at one point of time, there were only 10,000 pairs of human population, and then from there again they repopulated everyone.
There must have been no television at that
Why? Why people would sit watching television instead of populating?
Yeah. Yeah. See, I mean, like, coming back to that, I mean, like, today's time, a TV has become an outdated gadget. It was once upon a time an essential gadget at home.
Now on Netflix, Amazon Prime,
Yeah,
whatever.
I in fact, just last month I realized that the last time I recharged my TV was 6 months ago.
We don't have any TV at home.
Oh, shit.
It got spoiled and then we gave it away.
We had three, now we have one. So, yeah, pretty much same thing. Then I'm just saying, so it evolves. See, The genius of man is that he can adapt, he can change, whereas animals can only adapt. We can change the environment around us. We have that
But
power.
we belong to the animal kingdom also.
Yeah, that's only for social.
You mean to say a man can change his environment?
Yes, he can change his environment. He has a power, he has an ability, he has got the intelligence. I mean, it is, if you believe in God, it's a God-given thing.
Dominion over everything.
Yeah, dominion over everything. If you go by Exodus.
Not Exodus, Genesis.
Genesis, sorry, my bad. Genesis. If you go by Genesis, it is a man, dominion. But yeah.
But I feel he
His
with
quotes
all
are
this power and all, no, he. Like how the Spider-Man says, no, with great power comes great responsibility. I don't believe in that. I believe with great irresponsibility earns great power.
Come again?
Great irresponsibility earns great power. If you are, if you have a lot of power with you,
You'll become irresponsible.
no, you have earned it through irresponsible means.
Wow. Okay, that is deep. I wonder how many ministers listening to this will agree with you.
Okay, we won't talk about any ministers or anything.
See, actually, see, there was a time, I still don't remember if you know, there was a time, or I think there's a coming up. I don't know when I read this article, but I remember reading an article where they said that the consumption of coffee over the world is so much that there is not enough space to grow that much coffee, and hence.
Same with palm oil, I think. The same thing is happening, you know, Malaysia and all. The Indonesia, I think,
So,
some
no,
country,
I'm just
they are
saying.
just growing palm
Left,
trees
right, and
there.
center.
Yeah, they are like,
Deforesting and growing
yeah,
palm. Yeah, same thing was happening
Malaysia.
with in the
This is
Amazon.
greed.
Yeah,
This is greed.
it's greed. See, what I was saying, anyway. So, coming to that, there's a solution for that as well. If you go to, if you heard of a building called Taipei 101, have you heard of Taipei 101?
I wrote that like this, like that.
Yeah. Similarly, there is going to be in China a building which is going to be called, I can't remember, it is called something bowl. Because they're going to have alternate layers of residential and farming.
Oh, in Singapore already it's already in the
Yeah, in their, yes, they are in the airport, they have got a
yeah.
artificial rainforest. A freaking artificial rain freaking forest.
Why can't they have a real forest? I don't know. In Australia
Okay, it is a
also,
forest only, man. It's not artificial trees root, that's real trees.
I
They call it
know.
artificial because it's like on the 10th floor or the 9th floor or something. It's
In
elevated.
Australia also some colonies they're growing. It's very popular now.
Australia has an entire city that is underground. Do you know that?
Underground?
Yeah, it's an underground city because the heat was too much in the desert. I mean, I don't think it's populated anymore, but there is a city that was built totally underground so that they can escape the heat. I mean, it was a prison, right? I think.
I don't know.
Australia was a prison island.
Yeah.
I mean, these guys literally didn't have stuff. And they're thriving there now. They made it into a metro. Anyway, so what I was trying to get to is, there is no place. I mean, if it comes to it and we have, if man has to survive in Antarctica, they will survive. They may look weird, they may not look like anything like what men are now, because they may evolve if Darwin is right.
And what do you feel about the coronavirus and all? Do you think this has got to do
First
anything?
of all, very bad name for a virus.
Why?
Corona is like a good beer, man.
It's a beer named
Yeah,
Corona.
it's a Corona. The Corona was like, I read a meme somewhere. It's like, you
You
know.
don't make fun, okay? People are dying and shit.
I know, but I mean, like, there's a meme that says, why don't you have some Lyme disease with that corona virus? Corona and Lyme is a combination. I mean, like, why would they name it corona? I have.
Maybe some this you have not done biology, no? They
No. I don't know
maybe
biology.
all that classification of the organism comes in that this ray family genus and all.
Probably. Anyways. So when this
So
actually this disease didn't come from Africa, so much surprisingly.
no, from China, no?
That's what it didn't come from Africa. There's usually any disease you hear that come from Africa.
What?
Before this Ebola, Africa. AIDS, Africa.
No. AIDS didn't come from Africa.
Did it? No, not. It came.
No. AIDS first they discovered it in US, I think, AIDS. I don't
I'm pretty sure it was Africa. But anyways, that doesn't matter because my biology knowledge is little bit. Not a little bit, it's very bad actually.
So you're a climate skeptic or you're...
I'm a climate skeptic. I'm like, you know what, climate change may be happening, but it's the... I'm not saying it's not happening. I'm saying it is nothing to be alarmed about. Yes. I think people are panicking about it. I feel it's unnecessary. I know what you're trying to tell me, but I'm trying to tell you there are more people who are on your side than on my side, any which way, so it doesn't matter. See, I'll just give you and I'll tell you about it. Okay, it's like this, okay? If you come down to the fuel crisis and the things that are happening, everybody was like, fuels are running out. In 1990, there were a hell lot of production companies. I will not name any of them because they're all in question mark here. Because they had developed fuel, alternate fuel running vehicles. In fact, there are even speed cars meant for racing that do not need these hydrocarbon fuels. But the question is, why 20 years or 30 years now, since these things are made, are these cars not available to us? Reason? Kiching, 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 kiching. Simple, it's money. I mean, like, if they had to release those cars that time, the demand for fuel would drop, and they would not make money on... Or what, see, they have already invested onto the engines of combustion, internal combustion, hydrocarbon engines. So they have to get their money's worth. And whenever it is ready, they will pump it out. See, I mean, this is a risk-taking factor, but they were powerful enough to cover it. Because same thing Kodak tried to do with the film industry, and it backfired royally.
What?
Kodak invented the digital camera much, much, much before the first digital camera actually came. And they shelved it because they said, let's sell rolls. And then when it becomes obsolete, then we'll see. But then they forgot to patent it for reasons unknown to me.
Why? Yeah, that is stupidity.
Stupidity. So somebody else discovered...
patents are a whole different...
So somebody else invented a digital camera and launched it. And then they're like, hey, we thought of that first. And so, anyways, so they lost out a lot of business. Because Kodak was not the first on the scene. Other companies took up, and now people are buying Kodak cameras, and then now they don't buy anymore also. Now it's completely governed by somebody else. But yeah, that's a different story. So similarly, what I'm saying is, there are technologies, there are things that are already in place. Common people like you, me, and Tom, Dick, and Harry have no clue what's going on. We are all living our simple lives, fighting our simple battles. Every day is a battle. We don't have no idea what is happening on the higher realm of things.
So we are only pawns in the hands of
the big corporates. I'll tell you, the day the Y2K virus, I'm pretty sure Y2K virus was solved, not in a virus, in fact, the Y2K problem was already thought of and solved in a day. I mean, because when I read about the solution, I'm like, dude, this takes a day to bloody think of. Add two more digits to a day. Duh. So they did it, but then like, hey, you know what? Let's see how long it takes the normal people to guess it. Let's put it out in the market. All banks are going to close. No more transactions. We'll not know what to do. Electronics are going to go to the end. We'll have to go back to the ledgers. Yeah, whatever. The only thing that Y2K actually did is it gave a nice catchphrase, Y2K.
So everyone had to go and buy new software, huh?
Yeah, they just pushed people to buy it. Okay. It was just like two more letters.
So good marketing gimmick it was.
What good marketing gimmick? Precisely. Climate change is also pretty much on the same line.
What, do you think it's a marketing gimmick?
No, climate change is happening, dude. But the global warming, extinction, these are all... I'm telling you, very soon, somebody will start selling tickets to Mars saying that, you know what, Earth's getting over, let's go Mars. Fly Mars. Fly to Mars on speed airlines.
So you are... Let me be clear here. My position is man's greed is contributing to climate change.
I agree with you on that.
Man's greed
is coming to... what I'm saying is, there is climate change. Man's greed is causing climate change. What I'm saying is, man's greed will remove it from... rumors also from climate change.
You think there will be new technologies?
Exactly. They will come. So if all you know, you may get desalinized. I'll tell you, today, desalinizing water is a very expensive technology. They say it is too expensive to
do. Someone will come out with graphene or something like that.
Something will come cheaper. It will happen. Because, I mean, if Israel can do it, I think anybody in the world can do it.
No, but then what I was saying is, we learned this in thermodynamics. No, there's a second law. The entropy always increases or something.
Yes.
So whatever source of energy you pursue, nuclear, fossil fuel.
The overall energy will be the same.
No, for example, nuclear, if you release energy, it will cause global warming. You cannot have a clean source of fuel. What I'm trying to say is, see,
I
once.
understood what you're saying. You're saying the energy has to be spent, it will get transformed to last, is going to be heat. From heat, what it's going to go again.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. This way or that way, if you want something, a robot to do your work, physical
See,
work.
I'll go one more thing. I understand what you're saying. But even if you come to this point, you're saying that man is contributing. Not there. The center of the universe is a star. Or this universe that we're living in is a star.
Galaxy.
Is a sun.
Solar system.
Our solar system is a sun. Even that guy has an expiry date. I mean, like, you trying to save your rear end on here, and what do you come to know, like, 3 years after you have completely saved your rear end, the sun gives up.
That's still billions of years are there. But what I'm trying to say is, till that time, at least, we'll be able to migrate to another solar system.
Nah, I don't
we'll
think
we'll send 3D printers and logic along this, all our, what do you call this?
Technology?
No. All in that alien movie they send repopulating ships.
Repopulating.
In that you
not alien
send
movie,
the
alien. It was Alien 1, 2, 3.
You,
it was
you send the.
Oh wait, is that what was the name of the movie? It was a
species or
not
something.
Species. It is before Alien 1, 2, 3. Then it was a Alien 1, 2, 3, and then it was the preamble to it. It was called something. What they call the. What do they call
Prometheus?
It? Prometheus.
And then, I still get nightmares with that movie, man. What?
Amazing movie, man. Are you really? I loved it. It's one of my top 10 movies.
Michael Fassbender is that, this, no? Cyborg or something in that.
And I don't know actors' names, but amazing movie. The logic of that movie. And the thing was, I went for that movie not knowing that it is a prequel to Aliens 1, 2, 3. So that was like, what has happened?
No, but what I'm trying to say is, till the sun fails, we'll be somewhere else. That is quite assured. There is enough of time for us. But what I'm saying, we should survive till then.
We will survive till then, I'm sure. Not we, you and me as in, but yes, humanity will survive. I mean, see.
You have so much of faith in our species?
No, I have so much faith in science and technology.
But science and technology is a product of our species only.
Yes. I mean, the same thing, but yes. I mean, like, if they start killing off all the smart people, then maybe not. It has, see, I mean, just tell me one problem, except medical problem, because I have no clue why the doctors don't do solve problems. Or medical people put money into investing those, and maybe they're doing, I don't know anything about it. But you name one problem that man has not been able to face and solve. I mean, like today, even if you go to the medical field.
I'll give you one problem. Food, yeah. Hunger.
Dude, are you hungry?
No, not me. People
we have
are,
money, no?
People are, yeah, people
but
are.
But if the people had money, they would not be hungry.
No, that's what I'm trying to say. They're willing to work, but still they're hungry.
That is not to do with
that
human
Nobel,
beings.
Abhijit Banerjee got Nobel Prize for that only, no?
Correct, but see, you're not saying that he got a Nobel Prize in economy.
Yeah, he studies.
Yeah, it is economy.
No,
it is a man-made problem.
No, that's what.
See,
I'm,
if there is.
Yeah, I'm agreeing with you. It's a man-made problem.
Correct, but it is a problem that is a problem where the solution lies. See, there is no solution for that problem. Why? Because they don't want. Nobody wants to solve the problem. It is if 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. Everybody knows it, but if nobody's going to write it on the board, that is not going to get solved. And if you solve it, everybody comes on the same playing field. There's no fun in doing anything more.
So, you're saying something very drastic that there is fun in hunger.
I'm not. I'm just saying there's fun in being on the top of the scale. Is what is it?
But tomorrow,
I'll tell you anything very frankly. They have this. I don't know what it's called. Socialistic. I think it's called socialistic form of government where everybody gets equal pay no matter what work they do.
Not that. That's not socialistic. Socialistic is equality of opportunity.
Okay, but there are people. There was a kind of.
We are a socialistic, supposedly.
Supposedly, yes, that is a good word. See, there was a point. There is a kind of government system. I don't know very frankly what it's called, but where you know, no matter what you do, your pay scale is this much only.
Okay, then there's no incentive.
There is no incentive for development. Nobody gives a damn. They're like, I'm doing my job 9 to 5. Go to hell.
So you're pure capitalistic.
Yeah. I think this is the country where the Chernobyl happened.
No, that's communism.
Communism. In communism only.
Yeah, okay.
It's communism only, right? Where everybody is paid equal. So nobody gave
China
damn.
Also is communistic, but their whole economy is capitalistic when seen as a part of the world. But in their country, I don't know how they run it.
I have no clue about how they also run. But I'm just saying, if you see, even their there is no progress, there's no growth, because everybody is like, who cares? I'm not going to get anything more for doing this. It's in the words of our famous maids that we have, itna paisa mein itta chpilenga.
But the thing is, what I'm trying to tell you is, people waste food and some people are hungry. That is
correct.
It
is a problem that can be solved, Julian. A very simple problem that can
I
be solved.
Feel
if you go to Bombay, there are NGOs who actually go to wedding halls and pick up the excess food and give it. So there is a solution for it, I'm saying. But the willingness to do it is there or no is the important thing, is the thing. In countries where this is happening, there are people who are eating. There's not like the entire country is starving. It is that the people who are eating are just too greedy.
I know, greed is the major problem for
So that's what I was trying, getting back to the point. There is not a single problem that is there that man cannot solve. And I have faith in this.
But if he is not willing to solve, that's the problem.
That is the thing. But see, when it comes to survival, he's going to be willing to solve is beyond. See, at the max, I'll tell you what will happen. We'll have a.
But rally. At the max.
Worst comes situation, we will have Noah's Ark Part 2. Wherein the.
I just watched the movie yesterday.
Yeah, okay. The filthy rich are going to be like, okay, guess what? I don't like you, you, and you. You, and you don't get on my boat. You, get on my boat. You, what can you do for me? Okay, very good. Get on my boat. You, Indian, repair my computers, get on my boat. It's like that. It's going to be, you know, where they're selective. And in fact, I would be very pleased to have that kind of a system wherein you're actually selecting the best
of
the best.
What if you don't get on the boat then?
Pretty much sure I'm not going to get on the boat. But then still, I mean, like, if survival is going to be on based on things, I mean, they'll need a comedian one day or the other. But still, even if I don't make it, humanity is going to make it much further if they have people who are much intelligent and higher gene. You know, if they good gene
processing.
You're going
to be like, don't tell me you're going to do screening process like Hitler.
Yeah, that's what. If I had to be the owner of Noah 2.0, I would have a screening boss. I would screen you genetically and check. Okay, I'm like,
what?
Mental disorder chances. Good. Bye bye.
What I'll tell you what this.
I don't know what I would also do. I would not make it known that I'm doing it. First of all, I would screen everybody. And accordingly, I would put them in boats number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and it's a number. Okay, but only boat number 1 would have an engine. So that, you know, unless there's an uprising, if I keep saying
but
no,
what if you
there will be an uprising.
You don't get invited to the boats.
It's okay. I'm building the boat, dude.
There's no comedy there, no. Okay.
I mean, like, I'm just saying. I mean, see, we are, if you're a small part of the cog, you're a small part of the cog, man. You got the shit end of the stick. It's a shit end of the stick. You can't do anything about it. But I'm saying, had I had the chance...
What if tomorrow all the poor people became violent and started burning your house?
Exactly. That's why I said, no, I will put 10 boats and not tell them that they're getting screwed. Because if I tell them they're going to get screwed, they'll screw my boat. If you tell them, if you antagonize them, there is power in mass. There is power in numbers. You should always remember that. So being political and being diplomatic is very important to survive in any situation. You tell everybody, very good, very good. Jeans, you are awesome jeans.
But
you
why,
vote
you
number 10.
Why can't you give basic this people enough for them to actually have food and enough? Like, don't give them more money, give them less money, no. And enough to have food.
Have you heard of that camel and the nose and the storm story?
No.
Okay, there's a sheikh and he's going with a camel. An American guy, he's like, cost time has come to the desert, he's roaming with his camel. And there's a storm coming. So the guy who the camel taker is like, hey, sir, storm. He puts up his tent and he sits inside. Well, sandstorm has to pass. And then he's like, hey, what about the camel? The fellow, that boy who's a camel rider, says, no, sir, camel can survive. Hey, poor thing, it has worked hard. And, you know, it's equality of rights and it's a human thing. And he allows it to put his nose inside the tent. 2 minutes, the whole camel is inside the tent. The American and the rider out outside the tent. That's a similar case with if you go
so
to
you
give
think,
charity, they will come and push you out of your own house. Because see, what is your minimum basic, you say? You cannot define a minimum basic because every time you define a minimum basic, okay, that is going to affect your...
In America also, they have no food
Correct.
Stamps and all.
Yes, they have. That is okay. But what I'm saying is, the minute you define a minimum basic, okay? Yeah. So... It basically what I'm
Dave,
trying to
let me clarify, but I don't agree with anything that Sheldon is saying. If you anyone has any problem, you come and beat him only, please. Don't come to my house and worry me, please. I'm against all of this. I feel that because of no, forget. I feel that greed is the most stupidest thing ever, and we have to fight to get rid of it.
Greed is one thing. What I'm trying to tell you is, see, when you start giving it for free,
Why have you to give the entire thing? You give
no,
little bit.
give you a little bit. I'm saying, I'm trying to tell you that only. See, you define a minimum wage, okay? Minimum basic allowance to give somebody, say 100 rupees, okay? Now, because you are giving away 100 rupees, you are short of 100 rupees, okay? So now you will try to gain the 100 rupees more back because you're a businessman.
No.
No, that's what I'm saying. Business people do it. They want their 100 rupees back. They're not
No,
going to
that's
give it.
not giving.
No, they not from them, but they will try to get from somewhere else. Okay.
Okay.
So once they do that, they automatically the pricing of everything goes up. So as soon as that happens, that 100 rupees is not adequate now to live a normal life. Then that after some time is revised to 150. Then the same cycle continues till that cycle never ends. Understand what I'm trying to tell you? It's like this: if you have two bakeries, if aamne samne, one bakery starts selling at 10 rupees, the other fellow starts selling at 12 rupees, 10 rupees. Then this fellow, just to make the car, he'll make it 8 rupees. Then because this fellow made 8, he'll become 7, 6, 5, 4. At the end of one of them has to close down.
No, nothing. I mean, why can't both concentrate on what they have to do best now? Someone is selling buns, his buns are good. Someone is
That is
patties.
idealistic, but doesn't happen. This is theoretically.
Why can't you aim for utopian society?
You can aim for, but it is not just possible. It
It is
is
definitely possible.
not practical, at least. Possible, maybe not even practical. Julian, if without there is no competition, there is no growth. Remember this for sure. This is 110% fact of
So,
engineering, fact of
rat race.
it has to be a rat race. Just remember not to be the rat.
Then what? You have to be the
The
cat.
cat.
But if there are no rats remaining, then how the cat is going to eat?
And that's the same. No, that's why you encourage people to study, work under you, and continue the rat race. You give people things to aspire for, the rat race will continue. If everybody
So,
attained
according to
nirvana,
me,
if everybody attained nirvana, you tell me what you and I would be doing today.
no, we would be
Maybe since I'm
happy.
talking this nonsense,
No.
that is a different story. But I mean, there is no need to do anything except, you see, just imagine, Julian, you're getting your food every day at a particular time, whatever you want for the rest of your life without paying a rupee. Would you go to work?
No.
Exactly. So if everybody gets that, nobody's going to go to everybody attend nirvana. If everybody's satisfied with what they get, and they are not going to do anything. That's why you need the rat race. You need a little bit of common capitalism. You need a little bit of.
Okay, listen,
You need an imbalance. See.
I was surfing, okay? I came across a Japanese farmer, Masanobu
Oh, you remember the name? Okay.
Fukuoka. Okay, he was a microbiologist or a botanist or something like that way. He used to check the plants which were coming into the airport. And he used to work a lot with microscopes and all. So he went and experimented on his farm and all, and in the end he found that you don't need to do much work in order to grow food. For say, for example, a family of four has to work only 2 hours a day or something like that way to feed all of them, and means not greed,
I understood that.
need.
Need.
So this utopian society is very much possible,
Exactly what I'm trying to tell you. No, it is very possible, okay. But then there is
but
no.
even Gandhi or someone said it, no, that everyone's greed cannot be fulfilled, only need can be fulfilled.
No, that is okay. Okay, let's take that hypothetical situation that everybody is farming their own food, okay? What are the engineers going to do?
Engineers, why? We don't need engineers, we need only farmers. And
But
we
you are an engineer, I am an engineer. What are we going to do?
we are a product of today's corruption.
We are not a product, we are the product of greed. We are a product of need.
Engineers can devise those elemental tools, nah? What do you call that? Rake and all for harvesting and.
That's already invented, no?
Yeah. But we can just. We do farm work now. Nah? In his farm, many big educated people went and learned something.
Correct. That is okay for a cool weekend project or something. But I would not want to do farming all my life. What a computer engineer going to do when there's no electricity or the computer to run?
You can build spaceships now to colonize other this.
Christ have mercy. This guy want to colonize other countries,
Not
other
other
planets,
countries.
okay. Become a little rich here, no.
See, okay, fine. Everyone is eating good, means the need food, you know, not greed food. Everyone is eating need food. People have enough of time on their hands. Let people like let places like NASA, their budget will be increased 1,000 times because people don't need no, don't have to have all modern jacuzzis and swimming pools and big like lavish things in their house and all. So everyone can concentrate on things that are necessary, na? Then by the time the sun fails, we'll be easily go and colonize some other planet. We devote all our resources to that
Makes sense.
aim.
Makes sense.
Okay, finally we agree on something.
I'm just agreeing because it's a hypothetical situation. When it happens, wake me up from my grave and tell me, Shaila, I was right. Okay, so anyhow, what are we concluding on the topic that we actually were talking about? See, climate change is definitely happening. Whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, still open to debate, I say.
What if you don't survive climate change? Then, if your children, for your children's future and all, you have to save them. If they're not able to play in the playground because of the heat, and in Delhi, people are not able to play because of pollution, you have to do
We
something,
can do
no?
something, man. I mean, see, a place like Mumbai, there is no place to play. Now there are people places to play. Everybody has done horticulture on the terraces, and there are actual playgrounds where you pay 600 rupees an hour and play.
Oh, first we used to enjoy ourselves for no money at all.
I know that. That's what I'm saying. No, see, everything now is coming at a cost. What was free once is now getting paid, and for what we were paying for earlier, we're getting free of cost.
Like
Like
data.
in that data, internet, TV, television, entertainment. I mean, like, I used to wait for 1 month bloody for magazines to come and to read about cartoons. Now I like so many cartoons, I don't know which one to follow. It is a cycle, things happen. I mean, like, as I said, the bell bottoms could come back, a lot of
It's all
things can
about
come back.
demand, I think. If
It's all about demand, it's all about demand and supply.
if more
It is.
people desire to go to colonize some other planet, it will happen.
It'll happen.
But if no one wants any no everyone wants to eat meat, gone.
Yeah, it's something like that. And I'm at least I am one person who is for people turning vegetarian. I'm like, please do it.
So your meat will become less
Exactly,
costly.
yeah, my meat will become less costly. Yeah, so I hope all your people listening have to convert to vegetarian just to help me. Thank you.
It's like that, your laughter is like that evil king, no? Who's scheming all the time. And who has his.
Playing with his fingers.
Yeah.
Ho, my. Look at these many people. Yeah, so yeah, concluding our change is all happening. Change may be good or bad. In my opinion, and to my looking at how man has survived so far, I think that we can just lay back and relax and leave it to the scientists and engineers to do something. See, at the max worst thing, worst come worst, what the engineers and scientists will do is they will save their rear end and let everybody else rot. And okay, I mean, like, you should have studied science then.
What if the best genetics and all are with the poor people? Then what to do?
Bad luck. But
So
the poor survive.
that, yeah.
No, I'm just saying. I mean, like, see, I'm not saying that what I want to do should be something that everybody wants to do. I mean, like, if you watch that movie 2021, like it was called, where the entire world crumbles and there are some 10 or 11 mega ships.
No, I've not seen that movie.
Crash, not seen that movie. That is a funny movie. I mean, it is a serious movie, but I found it very funny, extremely funny. And it was a very funny movie. I will discuss it one day. You watch that movie and I'll tell you how it was a funny movie. Oh God, I can't.
So
Anyways,
what
so what
I
I
had
was
a,
saying was,
I
Noah
had a,
2.0 is the worst come scenario. We all living happily. Maybe it starts snowing in Goa for all you know. That is the best situation. So you can take anything. It can be this or this. I mean, like, as it comes, things will change. People will move on. I mean, see, China is a place that has earthquakes, I think, very frequently.
Japan.
Japan. But they still survive. You don't see them going and colonizing or taking over
But
other countries.
they choose their priorities well, no? They don't build they build houses out of lightweight materials and all.
Correct, but they have houses, no, all the same. They didn't give up and say, let's go to another country or let's wind up and stop building houses. It's just like that. It is a situational thing. It is man has the power. I mean, like Taipei 101, I think, is in Japan only, if I'm not mistaken. Taiwan, I think. I don't know.
Shanghai.
No, not Shanghai. Shanghai is going to come next to that big thing, bowl. It's called the bowl. Some bowl. The rice bowl or something. Anyway, see, what I'm trying to say is, the sky's the limit, man, for man. It still got chances. And worst to worst, we'll have to depend on Elon Musk to take us to some other country, some other planet. So, there is humanity ending. I have, if you had
Jeff
to put my money on it,
Jeff
I would have...
Bezos, what he said when he came
Amazon.
To India. Yeah, owner of Amazon. He also has a space company. He's saying he's going to move all the heavy manufacturing out of the planet. Maybe to Mars or somewhere.
Yeah, and then you know how costly Amazon stuff is going to come.
No.
Delivery from space, outer space, satellite landing in...
No.
Spacecraft will land, sir, in Indian Ocean on the 16th. You'll get that update.
Everything will be automated, I think.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't want to pollute the Earth. He wants to move all pollute Mars or some other place.
Yeah, like the Martians are going to let you come and pollute the country, their world. Ah, come, Earthlings. You come in peace? Very good. You brought your piece of shit too? Thank you. What I know of, what I understand is, all these outer space excursions are nothing to do with, it's my conspiracy theory at least. It is nothing to do with finding or rehabilitating Earth. It is about finding minerals. Just assume you find a gold mine.
He might actually use that Mars ka raw material only, no? He'll have everything.
Yeah, but you don't have to send
automated.
People there and manufacture.
No, all automated he might have. No, he might have everything.
That's one thing. They're not looking at rehabilitating Earth people. They're just trying to make money. More money.
Yeah.
More money.
Space race. Real space race.
Yeah, space race. Then you'll actually have, like, you know, it'll actually come one day if this Bezos does it. Yeah. Your Amazon delivery has just, the satellite has just landed in the Indian Ocean. The next update collection has happened. Then the next update. And that's how it goes. And that's how it goes. Anyways, I need sign off.
Okay, well, finally, we'll just say that I disagree with Sheldon. Please don't come and beat me up. Please don't come and beat me up. I think greed is the main problem, and Sheldon thinks greed is good for invention.
Yeah, bye.
Bye.